Alright, hello guys, in this video we're going to be talking about a huge tropical update on the entire season overall. We're going to be talking about basically the next couple of months, what we're going to be looking at as far as tropics, which has been a common recommendation from my viewers, and also we're going to talk about these three tropical storms that we have in the Atlantic in kind of the second half of this video. This one's going to be packed full of information, so I hope you guys really enjoy this one. Now, before I get started with this video though, I would ask that you do subscribe if you do like weather-related content, and also make sure to check out the links in the description for our social medias. Especially the Instagram. Again, I know I mention this every video, but we are doing a lot of work on that and we are trying to grow that significantly, and it has been going very well. So thank you guys for your continued support with that. Now, as you can see in the Atlantic, we have Jerry, Karen, and Lorenzo. We're going to be talking about all three of those individually and basically giving a little bit of an outlook there. Again, second half of the video, but first things first, we're going to be looking at basically the climate and looking into what we're going to be expecting over the October and November months, especially because we only have about, I think, 7 days left in September. I forgot how many days we have in September. Okay, yeah, 30. So, yeah, 7 days left in September. So we're going to be talking mostly about October and November in this one. Now, we do have a lot of warm sea surface temperatures in the main development region, which is basically from right off the coast of Africa through to the Gulf and kind of Hispaniola, Cuba, that area. And then having above average temperatures on the East Coast would help development if we had a storm enter that area, which over the next week or two doesn't seem very likely for the most part, at least north of Florida. So I'll talk more about that in a little bit. Now here's our CFS V2 200 millibar velocity potential anomaly. So you probably are wondering what in the world this even means. Basically, all you need to know is that in the green, we're dealing with favorable conditions, and then in the red, unfavorable conditions. And you can see this is the entire world, and you can see for the month of October, the CFS thinks that we're going to have very, very favorable conditions for the most part in the entire Atlantic, but mostly in the Gulf and right there to the east of the Bahamas. So those are two very important regions in tropical activity, especially this time of year. As we head later into the year, the Gulf becomes more and more important as we see a little bit less hurricanes come off the coast of Africa, and we look more towards the Gulf and right along the East Coast. So seeing these areas in the favorable conditions is very, very interesting at this point. Now here's your November outlook as well, and it's going to be a little bit lower resolution, a little bit lower confidence because this is further out into the model's run, obviously, but for now, they do have a little bit of green there located near Hispaniola and near Cuba in the Bahamas, so again, maybe some favorable conditions for the Gulf or at least in the Bahamas and Caribbean area. Now, we do have unfavorable conditions there for Africa, which isn't going to matter too much because by time November comes around again, we don't usually see much activity come off of Africa as it is, so that shouldn't affect things too much, I don't think. Now, here is kind of going to be an outlook for the next week or so, as long as we have this pattern in place. The black line is where we're going to have storms heading from Africa and see where they head. And then those two red areas is where we have a lot of really above average heights, and that's going to discourage storms from entering those two red areas. So you can see the East Coast is looking safer than normal for the next little while, as well as the Gulf Coast a little bit, though I'm a little bit more concerned about the Gulf Coast as we're going to get into it, but we're going to see storms most likely head into this kind of gray area. This looks to be the most favorable area for storms to head into as long as they're heading from Africa in the main development region. It looks like they're going to head into these areas, which again is pretty typical. There is a little bit of a region where they can head through north of Hispaniola and to the east of the Bahamas and maybe get through and head towards Bermuda, as I think we're seeing one of our storms do here. And also, if they head north that way, they can curve back west and maybe hit Florida or head in that area at least. And that's another possibility we're seeing with one of our current storms. But it is also possible that they do head south of Cuba and south of Hispaniola and south of Jamaica and head towards Mexico and the Gulf of Mexico as well, which would be interesting. And in a pattern like this, that's usually the most typical outcome. That's usually what we see when we have a high pressure system in the eastern United States. We usually see these systems head into the Gulf, so we'll have to see what happens here. But for the next week or maybe more, this looks to be the best, most likely outcome for most storms. Now, first things first, we're going to be looking at Tropical Storm Jerry here. And on satellite, we're not looking too hot with this one. Now, you can see right there in the middle of your screen, we do have kind of the center of rotation there, or the center of low pressure. And you can see there's not a lot of tall clouds next to it or even near it. It is kind of far off. And what we typically see when this happens is we're seeing very, very high shear kind of tear the top off of this storm. That's exactly what we're seeing here. So not looking too hot for Jerry. Looks like he's on the way down as far as intensity is concerned. And you can see it's going to head just to the north of Bermuda as a tropical storm and maybe stay a tropical storm. I don't think it's going to stay a tropical storm till Saturday. I think it's dying very, very quickly. And I think it's going to be less than a tropical storm by that point. As we look at our model guidance, as far as spaghetti models are concerned, they have it basically heading out to sea. The United States is almost certainly safe from this one. Besides Bermuda, you're at a little bit of a risk, but even Jerry looks to head a little bit further north. You might get some showers and a little bit of gusty winds, though. You can see, here's our intensity guidance for Jerry. We're on the way down. We're at a pretty moderate tropical storm now, but is a downtrend from here. So Jerry looks to be weakening. The shear is finally getting to him. And as he heads north, the waters are getting colder and colder. Now, your next storm that we're going to be talking about is Karen, which is just south of Puerto Rico. On satellite, she still hasn't developed quite a lot yet. We do see some tall clouds in there, which gives us some potential for some pretty good development here. But you can see we're still in the very, very early stages of development here with Karen. Now, looking at NOAA's forecast and cone of uncertainty for this one, this is the one I was talking about where we're going to see this one head north and to the east of the Bahamas and then maybe curve directly west and then possibly head towards Florida eventually. We're gonna have to watch it very closely as we have high pressure system to the north of where this one curves. I don't see much else place for this one to go. It's either gonna weaken or most likely head in the direction of Florida, Cuba, and the Bahamas. I think that's the most likely outcome with this one, though we're still pretty early, so a lot of different things can happen at this point. Here's your model guidance as far as spaghetti models are concerned, and we have this one hitting Puerto Rico almost directly, but you can see before we hit 30 degrees north, most of the models have this one curving directly west and heading towards the Bahamas and Florida. There is a couple that keep it heading north, but with the current pressure and the current pattern that we're seeing in the United States and in the Atlantic, I don't see heading north of this point as much of a likely outcome as heading directly west towards the Bahamas and Florida, but it is possible that it does do this and head towards Bermuda as well. So we'll keep a very close eye on this storm. Now, here's your intensity guidance for this one, and we're at a very, very weak tropical storm. A couple models have it going back under tropical storm status outside of that green square there, but we do have a lot of them heading on the uptrend and towards a Category 1 hurricane. So we're gonna have to watch this one very, very, very closely. Now here's your third tropical storm we're going to be talking about, and this one is named Lorenzo, and he's right in the main development region, and on satellite, this one's looking the best out of the three, in my opinion. You can tell that there is some rotation and very tall clouds, so this one's looking really good and has a lot of potential to develop, so it's going to be interesting to see what we see happen with this one, because see, the National Hurricane Center has this one heading basically west, slightly northwest, and then eventually curving more and more north. It doesn't look like this one's going to head towards the United States quite yet, but we'll have to see because things could trend south and we could see this one heading towards the Gulf or towards the United States, in which case we'll have to keep a very close eye on this one. But you can see that we do have H's there, meaning they do expect this one to become a hurricane shortly. Here's your spaghetti models, and again, they have it heading west, slightly northwest, and then curving further and further north. So this one, as of right now, doesn't seem like it's going to pose much of a threat to the United States, but things can switch on a dime and change very, very quickly. We're at a weak tropical storm with this one as well, but the uptrend seems very, very sharp here, as in 48 hours, we have about a 50% chance of being a Category 1 hurricane, and I'll couple of these models have it going over Category 3 status, so this could be our next major hurricane here in Lorenzo, but we'll have to watch and see as we'll have future hurricane updates, obviously, as we head further and further and further into the hurricane season. And as always, especially the ones that look to impact the United States, I'll be doing even more frequent updates than the ones that are going to head out to sea, but maybe we'll do another tropical update like this one and just kind of show you guys what's happening. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you really enjoyed it. Like the video if you did enjoy it, let me know. And if you have any video suggestions, leave them down below. I want to start taking suggestions because some days I do kind of fall short on ideas and I am running out of ideas. I have in the past had ideas. That's how I've kept my video streak alive for 3 months, but I am kind of falling short on ideas as we're kind of in a slow time of year where there's not a lot going on besides some tropics and a few mountain snowstorms, but it's really been quiet. So again, if you have suggestions, leave them down below. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great week, have a great month, and have a great fall season, and hopefully none of you get hit by any hurricanes. See you guys in the next video.